So, I'm James.
And I'm Josiah.
And I'm Rainy.
And for our project, we decided to do analysis on mission planning software. And so mission planning software, basically, it maps out an area, and it's used for the mapping of different areas or for specific routes. There's different kinds of maps that we can use. You can do a grid-like formation to map out a rectangular area. You can do follow lines, so like you can map out pipelines or rivers or streams or anything like that. And well, for our experiment, we decide to map out three different softwares with three different drones to find out which drone was most precise and to see if if there was more steps that required to map out a flight, if that would mean a more precise or more accurate measurement or mapping of an area.
So to do that, we recorded the steps that it took in downloading the app, setting up the flight plan, and then executing the actual flight path. So we did that with three different softwares. We used Precision Flight, Drone Deploy, and Pix4D Capture with three different types of drones. So we also used a Mavic Pro, a Phantom 4, and an Inspire. And so these images are extrapolated data that we, the orthomosaics that we inputted into ArcGIS Pro, and then basically, to calculate that, we drew lines around the airstrip. The black line indicates the base map, and then the blue line indicates drone deploy, the red one is precision flight, and the purple one is Pix4D. And to calculate the offset, we use the measure tool to measure like from the top corners to the bottom corners. But for the Phantom flight, for some reason the drone deploy run didn't capture the whole airstrip. It just had the X's, like a really thin image and the X's, so we used triangles. But those indicate like the precision and the accuracy of the softwares, and we have graphs over here that show like a different visualization of that data, and then also an ease of use analysis.
Yeah, so overall we found that the drone deploy software was both most precise in its flight plan image capturing, and it was also the app that we found was easiest to use. So this contradicted our hypothesis. So we thought that like the apps that were more precise would be like a little bit harder to use. They would have more steps and require more setup. So we thought this was pretty interesting. So a few of the reasons that we thought this could be caused by include the fact that the drone deploy app had a higher version number, so it's possible that it's like more refined than the other companies, and that it also may just be like the best flight app for this simple flight plan. We just did like a very basic like app and bag at this one airstrip. So a few limitations include the lack of repetition. So for the Inspire, and the Phantom, we just went out one day and did one run for each of the software. But for the Mavic, we went out on two separate occasions, and same thing, ran through all softwares on both of them. So we also compared the differences between the days and ran an ANOVA, but we found that there was no statistically significant difference between any of the softwares for both of the Mavic flights. So yeah, lack of repetition with the two other drones used, and lack of variation flight plan. It would have been interesting to see if any of the softwares were more efficient at mapping like tallied up the number of steps that it took to set up the app, but that might not actually lend to being easiest to use. So if you're going out and you want to do like some really complex data collection that has a bunch of different parameters, if it doesn't like provide you with those steps right off the bat, you may have to like search through the app to find them. And then also in doing our GIS analysis, the base map that we used had a really awful projection and was not very easily correctable in GIS, so we ended up projecting our ortho mosaics in the same base map. That may have caused a little bit of distortion. And then inputting a few of the ortho mosaics, like you can see in the Mavic flight software run, some of them are a little bit curved. Mm-hmm. And then, one of them was like substantially larger than the others.
Was that curved in real life, or is that just visually looks curved once you project it?
Visually, it looks curved once projected. So that is likely to have caused some error in our measurements. We didn't take into account the like surface area map. We just measured the distance of offset. So some recommendations for the future would be greater repetition across software and platforms, and increased variation of light path. And so the issue with the base map could be avoided by finding aerial imagery for our local area that has a better projection. The imagery that we found we had to pay for, so we just decided to use the base map and project into a given projection. And then also for the future, it would have been interesting to use a few of the planning software that weren't just free to download. So we chose these three because they gave you trial runs. So it would be interesting to see, like, to use like top of the line